I want to say something now that some of y'all might not like, and actually I don't really care, but I'm going to say it anyway. The other thing that I see in all those cities that connects them, there's a through line, there's a core, it's an immoral core that kind of unites all those cities and connects them to a really cold reality. And that cold reality is what I just said, but in every one of those cities, there's a political class. There's a mayor, there's a city council, there's a school board. There are groups of people who are college educated and doing fairly well in life who like to stand up and say that they're in a world-class city. Who ever heard of a world-class city where kids can't read? San Francisco is the wealthiest county in California, and they have black kids that are doing worse than the state. How do you make sense of that? How do you wake up in the morning as a mayor and say, I have a world-class city? Well, let me tell you how you do that. You're not on the hook for educational outcomes in your city, in city after city after city. It is possible as a mayor to be elected without ever encountering a serious or thoughtful question about public schools or public education. It is possible to run for the presidency of the United States and never encounter a thoughtful question about academic outcomes for kids. How is that happening?